Hello students, I am Rajeshwar, your geography teacher. We were there on chapter number 3, major landform of the earth. Earlier we have discussed about the continents, mountains, plateaus, basin and valleys. Now we will discuss about the plains. Plains or lowland are the vast nearly flat expanse of land which are usually less than 200 meter high above the sea level. These plains are formed by the deposition of alluvium by the rivers, and therefore we call them the river plains. Sometimes these plains are found along the coast and we call them coastal plains. On the basis of their formation, plains are of three types. First of all, structural plains. Structural plains are found near the coast of a sea or a ocean. These plains are formed by the endogenic movement of the earth's surface when a sea floor rises upward above the surface and sea waves deposited the sediment with this raised platform close to the sea, and after a particular period of time this area becomes flatter than the original one. Structural plains are border all countries. The coastal plains of southeastern USA near the Gulf Coast, which are the part of the Great Plains of the world. The plains of northern Russia and the central lowland of Australia are other example of structural plains. After that, erosional plain, as the name suggests, means the plains which are formed by the erosional activity of the agents, or the agents, those who mostly perform the erosional activity like the wind, river, rain, ice. But they do when the river come from the mighty mountains or lofty mountains, they cut down the mountains and they erode the mountains, and after a passage of time these mountains are merged with the plain. And the plains which are formed by this activity are called the erosional plains. The plain of northern Canada, northern Europe and Kashmir in India are example of such type of plain. Next is depositional plain. As the name suggests, means the plains which are formed by the sediments brought down by the large river or the other natural agents like wind, ice. They are known as the depositional plain because they deposit the sediment in the lowland areas. For example, Indo-Gangetic plain is the plain of depositional type. These plains are very important for us. In history, we know that early human civilization was settled along the river valleys, like the Mesopotamian Valley, Indus Valley, or the Hwang Ho Valley is the example of this type of areas or this type of plains. Now the importance, plains provide the flat area for the human settlements because humans can do agriculture, they can make their houses in flat areas and they can construct roads. Crops such as wheat, sugarcane are grown in plain areas, or the plain areas are also known as the granaries of the world. Large cities and towns are located mostly in the plain areas. The scope for industrialization is much more in plain areas when we compare with the other areas. Soft and flat surface of the plain makes it easy for the construction of road and railway transportation. Now some other feature like the minor landforms. Islands. Island is a piece of land which is surrounded on all sides by water. India has two group of islands, like you are able to see Andaman and Nicobar Island, Lakshadweep. Sri Lanka is also island because it is also surrounded by water from all sides. Madagascar is one of the big island which is there in the ocean close to Africa. Next is the peninsula. Peninsula is a piece of land that is surrounded by water on three sides and joined to a large landmass. The peninsular plateau of India is also example, like Here is Peninsular Plateau of India. It is surrounded by water from three sides. Like west, Arabian Sea is there. In the east, Bay of Bengal. And in the south, Indian Ocean is there. And in the north of it, Asia continent is there. So we call it Peninsular Plateau of India. Or you can say in the north of this Peninsular Plateau, North India is there. These are their isthmus. Isthmus is an elongated narrow piece of land which join the two large land masses and separates two water body. Isthmus of Panama is an example of isthmus. Like this isthmus join the two large land masses, North America, South America, and separates two water body, Pacific Ocean and Atlantic Ocean. That's why we call it isthmus. Landform affect the life of human being in many ways, such as when there is an earthquake or a volcanic eruption which cause severe loss to human life and property. The nature of rock and soil that a particular landform is made up, which is also a crucial as determine whether or not human can dwell safely on it or not. Landform also influence weather. Higher one goes, it colder it gets. While down in plain or valleys, it is warmer. Since landform affect the climate of area, it is more difficult to grow crop on a hill slope, to dig well on a hill slope, to construct road on a hill or a mountain, than to construct a road over the plain area. We can easily dig a well in plain area. We can easily do the agriculture in plain areas. So life in plain areas is much more easier when we compare with the mountain or other areas. Our next topic is influence of the India's geographical feature on shaping its history. India is almost as big as a continent. Hence, India with its neighboring countries are referring as a subcontinent. India is bounded by Himalaya in the north and by the sea on three sides in its south. Himalaya work as a climatic divide between India and the other countries, and also it serves as a natural border which protect India from the invaders. Mountain passes along the northwest of the country also acted as a trade route through which many groups such as the Central Asian come into this country. Many seafaring nations used the sea route along the coast for trade and interaction. India is land of rivers. People referred to live in river valleys such as Ganga River Valley, Indus River Valley, Narmada. They provide the water and the fertile soil or plain areas to the human being to do the cultivation. Where in the river valleys, ancient civilization flourished. People from the north moved to south and those from the south moved to north, crossing Vindhyas and Satpuda mountains, numerous rivers and the Deccan.